HitFilm is a unique product that combines two features that are not normally found together in one application. HitFilm contains a very functional nonlinear editor timeline alongside a hugely powerful compositing workshop. As recent updates to HitFilm have added far more functionality and power to the editor timeline with text tools, keyframe animation, and brand new to HitFilm 13, masking in the editor, it will be helpful for new users to understand the differences between the two timelines and when to use them. The editor timeline is where you put together sequences of shots to create your show or program from beginning to end. Whether it's a vlog, vacation video, gaming video, music video, documentary, short film, full feature, or anything else, the editor timeline is where this happens. A composite shot is simply a holder that creates a virtual media clip, which is treated as a regular video clip in the editor timeline. A composite shot is intended for creating complex layered effects or detailed animations, which can be pre-rendered and treated as a single clip in the editor. Composite shots provide 2D and 3D layer-based compositing with powerful tools like an advanced particle simulator, live 3D object rendering, over 800 built-in effects and presets, planner tracking with a special version of Mocha from Imagineer Systems, an integrated 3D camera solving tool with a Foundry's camera tracker, and a unified 3D workspace. The fundamental difference between the editor and a composite shot is the editor is track-based while a composite shot is layer-based. A track can contain multiple pieces of media. A layer can only hold one single piece of media. A track on the editor timeline may contain media laid one right after another to form your project. Composite shots are built using layers. Each layer contains a single asset, for example, a video, an image, a particle effect, a 3D model, etc. These layers can be heavily customized by applying transformations, drawing masks, adding effects, and more. The compositing tools in HitFilm work directly alongside the editor. Switching between the editor timeline and a fully CG visual effects composite shot is as simple as clicking a tab. Another important difference is the full suite of audio tools, most importantly of which is the multi-track audio mixer. These tools are only available in the editor timeline. Certainly, one's audio mix should be done in the editor timeline. Certain video editing tools such as slip, slide, ripple, and roll editing are also unavailable in the composite shots. The editor timeline does have a lot of powerful tools for effects, for masking, and for 2D animation. In fact, you can do a wide range of projects entirely in the editor and never need to use a composite shot. The editor, however, cannot read 3D models, work in 3D space, or use any effects in the effects list labeled layer only. The editor timeline and composite shot have many overlapping functions, but they are constructed in fundamentally different ways and have fundamentally different intents for use. The advantage of the HitFilm workflow is being able to switch back and forth from the editor and compositor immediately without the need to switch programs. A common editing workflow in HitFilm might be as follows. Start your new project, import your media files, organize and assess your media in the media bin, trim your media using the trimmer, add your media clips to the editor timeline, use the timeline tools to further refine your edit, convert certain clips as needed into composite shots for complex VFX work, create your visual effects within each composite shot of your project, adjust the audio levels, add transitions and other miscellaneous effects, and finally export your finished product. I hope this has been a helpful guide as to the difference between the editor timeline and a composite shot in HitFilm. This is Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Please hit the like button and subscribe for more content like this. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.